What would you do if you fell asleep on the train on your way home and woke up to a train filled with souls of dead people, animals, and plants on their way to leave the world of the living? That is what you explore in What Comes After, developed by Fahmitsu and Rolling Glory Jam in this brief narrative adventure coming soon to the Nintendo Switch. And as you learn more about love, sorrows, life and death, you soon realize that the journey is just half of the story. A story that will stay with you for a long time after you put down the Switch after finishing the game. Meet Vivi, a young girl that lives with her mother to help her out in the family-owned store, and she has a sister that also visits on the weekend to help out. Vivi's story starts when she is on her way home on the train and falls asleep before her stop and wakes up when a strange cat confronts her. As the initial panic sets in and she slowly realizes it's dark outside and she is all alone on the train, to make matters worse, the train now starts to move again. There are no spoken dialogue, so there are some audible cues and also some dialogue written in all capital letters and even shaking letters to further enhance the seriousness or the surprise in her voice. This works remarkably well, and no matter who you interact with, you quickly start to find their voices in your head as you read their dialogue and form a bond. What Comes After is a personal story about learning to love yourself, a subject that is rare in video games, and it's cleverly mixed with a sprinkle of comedy and philosophy. But when you start to walk, or jog for that matter, into the nearest railway cart, you will meet your first souls of dead people and can listen to their stories. Because you are on a train that transports souls after they have died, in and around 10 kilometers from the station. I know it's fairly precise distance, but who am I to question death? And on very rare occasions, a living person gets to ride along to its destination and back, and it's this key element that the game will base its whole storyline on. On the trains are souls from people, animals and even plants, and it becomes your task to listen to the stories and perhaps learn something for yourself as you help them come to terms with a new challenge. And their stories are filled with regrets of missed opportunities, to anticipation to meet family members that are already dead and hopefully awaits them on the train's destination. To the rich trying to buy their way back to the living, and the ones filled with remorse from missing out on family time due to working too much. And these stories are stories we can all understand, relate to, and probably might even know one of these persons in real life. What Comes After is an easy game to play with its minimal number of buttons to press for you to navigate around, but it's also a deep game with an important message. And as you continue through the different carts, you will soon realize that not only humans, but also animals and plants have souls. For some, that might appear far-fetched, but the stories never seem off or there for just comedy relief. And when you hear the stories about human love, cruelty, and wickedness towards them, you might have a hard time to take it all in. But even if the developers have mixed humor and serious topics in this game, it's easy to laugh when a bunch of mushrooms play deaf to simply avoid you since they believe that you will stop and eat them. Many of the stories from the animals are not there for dramatic effect, but rested on real-life events and in line in how we treat everything around us. There's also stories of the same type of anticipation that humans experience in facing death. What Comes After is a game that will keep you occupied for around 1.5 hours of gameplay, and with a price of €6.99, I think that is a decent price for the journey you will embark on. Even though replayability is low, since these type of games usually are a once-in-a-lifetime playthrough, it's a story with colorful art, the music is splendid, and the whole spirit of the game is presented in a positive way, even if you travel on a train not meant for the living. Pre-order starts on the 18th of March, and the game is set to be released on the 1st of April. Links to the EU and US stores are in the description below. It has an age rating of 10+, and even if there are no jump scares or violence, I think some of the topics in this game could be hard to comprehend for a 10-year-old. So perhaps sit down and play together with your child to explain some of the topics discussed in the game. The game gets bonus points for their ability to pet animals. And when the credits roll and you hear the outro music, I suggest you stay in the game, because like any good movie, there are details to experience if you watch it all the way to the end. But you know what? Let's not end this journey here. We have talked about the gameplay, the story, the soundtrack, and also what will you get if you decide to buy this game and play it. So to give you a chance to experience even more amazing indie games, I have added another video that I think that you will love to the upcoming end screen. So I will see you there, and until next time, stay safe and stay awesome.